Hello everyone, my name is Irena Tarnawsky, and I'm here with another virtual performance, this time for St. Patrick's Day. I'm here in my home music studio recording for you. Because the COVID restrictions are still in place and I cannot come to visit you in person, that makes me sad. I'm going to start my performance with a song from this book. It's titled The Fairy Thorn by Jerry and George Armstrong. And I'll start with a little poem. I'll Wear a Shamrock by Mary Carolyn Davies. St. Patrick's Day is with us, the day when all that's seen to right and left and everywhere is green, green, green. And Irish tunes they whistle, and Irish songs they sing. Today each Irish lad walks out as proud as any king. I'll wear a four-leaf shamrock on my coat the glad day through. For my father and mother are Irish, and I am Irish too. Especially on St. Patrick's Day. This song is titled Finvarra, the King of the Fairies. In Celtic mythology, Finvarra was a fair-haired, very handsome, benevolent figure who ensured a good harvest and provided great riches to those who assisted him. He lives in County Galway with his queen, Una. Finvarra, the King of the Fairies. Enjoy. King of the Fairies. There's a lot to celebrate in March. The spring equinox marks the end of the dreary dark days of winter and the official beginning of spring. And of course, there's St. Patrick's Day on the 17th. Whether you're Irish or not, you're probably looking forward to celebrating this very fun holiday. This is titled St. Patrick's Day Jig by Barbara Walker and Carmen Elkin. Thank you. one of the world's most popular saints. He was born in 387 AD in Roman Britain. And when he was 14 or so, he was captured by Irish pirates during a raiding party and was taken to Ireland as a slave to herd and tend sheep. At the time, Ireland was the land of the Druids and pagans. Pedric's captivity lasted until he was 20, so about 6 years, when he escaped after having a dream from God in which he was told to leave Ireland by going to the coast. Sure enough, there he found some sailors who took him back to Britain, where he was reunited with his family. This is entitled Gaelic Melody. Escaped Ireland and his years of slavery there and returned to his family, you can imagine that there was much rejoicing. A few years after returning home, he had a vision which prompted his studies for the priesthood. He was ordained by Saint Germanus, the Bishop of Auxerre, whom he had studied under for years, and later was ordained a bishop himself and sent back to Ireland to introduce the gospel. This one is called Drowsy Maggie, and it's very popular fiddle tune, and unfortunately I'm not a fiddler, so I will do my very best. It's a reel, and reels are dances of Scottish origin with two distinct parts and two different melodies. So here we go. You might want to give me some clapping. Thank you. those of you who've seen some of my other videos recognize this little dog. She's my schnauzer, Ziva. We named her after Agent Ziva David from NCIS. Ziva's 4.5 years old, and she walks in and out of the studio. Sometimes you'll hear her barking, or if she likes something, she might even give a little howl. Anyway, just thought I'd introduce her to you again, wearing her little green and white and red collar. Bye, Ziva. Yeah, good girl. Oh, yes, good girl. Want to sit here? Okay. When Patrick arrived in Ireland in 433, there are several legends about what happened next. The most prominent claiming that he met the chieftain of one of the Druid tribes who tried to kill him. And after an intervention from God, Patrick was able to convert the chieftain and preach the gospel throughout Ireland. This next one is titled Hymn, and it's by the Greek composer Vangelis. He composed electronic music, jazz, ambient music, relaxation, spa type of music, as well as orchestral film and TV scores. And this has definitely a Celtic feel. It recorded in 1979 for a commercial for E&J Gallo Winery. Maybe you've had Gallo wine, or maybe you can request some. Enjoy. Hey, see if you can sit here. Okay. Preaching the gospel throughout Ireland, he converted thousands of people, established monasteries, churches, and schools. He often used shamrocks with the three leaves and one plant to explain the Holy Trinity, and entire kingdoms were eventually converted to Christianity after hearing Patrick's message. He worked many miracles and wrote of his love for God in his book, Confessions. After years of living in poverty, traveling, and enduring much suffering, he died March 17th, 461. This is Keegan's Waltz, traditional melody with lyrics by Matthew Myers from 2014.
With the soft moonlight in your lawn. of strife. I prayed that when the war was over, I'd make you then my wife. I knew not how, I could not see. I shouldered spear to leave, but you stopped in your song and you turned aside and smiled down at me. Blue, you waved to me and said, would I leave my great sword and talk to you by yonder tree ahead? My sword I left by that great tree. It still is standing there, for I knew in my heart God answered me and heard my silent prayer. I saw you in the window there as I did pass.
Legend has it that St. Patrick was buried in the Hill of Down in Downpatrick, 33 kilometers south of Belfast in Northern Ireland. In the early 1900s, so many pilgrims who traveled there were removing soil from the holy site that a large flat granite slab was installed to stop them from doing this. It has the inscription of a Celtic cross and the name Patrick, marking the legendary burial place of the Apostle of Ireland. There's also a visitor center with the world's only permanent exhibit of the life of St. Patrick. It'd be one place I would like to visit someday. My next song has two titles, Simple Gifts, written in 1848 by Joseph Brackett Jr. He was an elder of the Shakers from Maine, U.S., and his lyrics are the middle section. And The Lord of the Dance was written by the English poet Sidney Carter in 1963. And in 1996, the dancer Michael Flatley popularized this tune in his musical, Lord of the Dance. I know you're going to recognize this one.
Dance, dance, wherever you may be. I am the Lord, and the dance, said he.
You did too. In the 1840s, Irish peasants came to Canada in vast numbers to escape a famine that has swept Ireland. Year after year, from 1846 to 1852, the potato crop failed because of a potato blight. Unable to pay the rent, families were evicted from their homes by ruthless landlords and made the decision to migrate to the US, to Australia, New Zealand, and Canada. It's estimated that 1.2 million Irish landed in Canada between 1825 and 1970, most of them arriving during the famine years and establishing themselves in this new welcoming land. This ballad was written by Thomas P. Westendorf in 1875. He was a German-American composer and teacher, and it's not an Irish ballad, even though everyone thinks it is. Performed by many Irish soloists, Mitch Miller, Elvis Presley, Johnny Cash, and of course, Bing Crosby. I'll take you home again, Kathleen. Across the ocean wild and wide.
In soft shoes with crisscrossed laces. At one time only men danced it, but now mostly women dance the slip jig, especially in competition. It is very graceful with pointed toes and high kicks forward and backward, and it's often called the ballet of Irish dance. And if you've ever seen young Irish dancers, little girls with the beautiful curly hair, and the green dresses and sort of the cape and their hands always tucked, then you've seen them dancing a slip jig. This one is called A Blast of Wind.
Different costume. This is a blouse that I purchased when I was in Ukraine in 2018. It's a hutsul embroidered design, and I've got my grandmother's korali, her coral beads. I've always thought that there is a connection between the Irish and Ukrainians, and I'm going to do a little set of Ukrainian music for you. When I was taking folklore courses at the university years ago, I realized that there was an interrelation between the two nations. The mass immigration, because of economic reasons. There's a similar joie de vivre amongst the people, folk traditions, the music, the songs and dance is so important, humor, superstitions, politics and religion, respect for the land, and the nations both experiencing a horrible famine. This first one is a folk song titled Ishumit Ihudem. It's a flirtatious song. A young gal is a little concerned because she sees rain clouds in the distance and wonders who will escort her home. Along comes a young fellow, a Kozak, and he says, "Don't you worry, I'll make sure you get home safely." And then she shares her anxiety. What will her mother think when she sees him bringing her daughter home? Now, I think this girl has plans for this guy.
Бо серед то матер маю бути мені.
ж молотою та хазяйкою звав.
Yes, she definitely has plans for this young fellow. Just like Ireland has its famous writers and poets, James Joyce, William Butler Yeats, so too does Ukraine. And this is a song with lyrics by Taras Shevchenko, considered the bard of Ukraine. In addition to being a writer, a poet, he was a wonderful painter, a folklorist, a political activist. He was born a serf in 1814, and his freedom was purchased by his artist friends when he was approximately 24 years old. Shevchenko is considered to be the father of the modern Ukrainian language. This is a pastoral, or actually a nocturne, and it's a setting in the evening where everyone is coming home from working in the fields, and mother has supper laid out by the house outside because it's very warm. And all the children fall asleep and she settles down next to them. And the only thing awake are the laughing girls and the nightingale. Popular with young and old. It's about another cherry orchard, another young girl, a kozak, and a nightingale, the soloveiko. And in the chorus, the singers imitate, the sound that the bird might make. This one is so popular, you'll hear it at summer camps, you'll hear it around, a campfire with friends on a bus trip, if you're going with a Ukrainian choir or what have you. So enjoy. Oi u vishnevomu sadochku.
Thank you.
I think you heard that nightingale. I hope you did.
One thing that the Irish and the Ukrainians definitely have in common is the love of dance. If you've ever been to a Ukrainian dance concert, you will have seen a kolomeika, but you may also have seen a kolomeika danced in a large circle at a wedding or at a zabava, and everyone takes turns showing off with all of their tricks and dance steps in the very middle. So I'm going to end this little set with a kolomeika by Bohdan Shiptur.
Set of Ukrainian music. Recently, geneticists and archaeologists studying genomes and DNA of prehistoric Bronze Age skeletons found in Ireland have concluded that thousands of years ago, as far back as 4,000 years ago, their ancestors came from the steppes or the prairies of the Black Sea region, located mainly on the territory which is Ukraine. These Celtic people migrated from East Central Europe. Perhaps that explains my attachment to all things Irish, even though my ancestors are Ukrainian many generations back. I'll get back to some St. Patrick's music as soon as I change.
Over the last year, my piano students have only had lessons intermittently because of restrictions and closures. But I do have two boys who agreed to film themselves. Now they are playing from lead sheets. That means they have the melody line, but the accompaniment is something that they have created on their own. I hope that you enjoy their performance. They will introduce themselves.
Hi, my name is Stefan Podilsky and I'm 15 years old. And today I'll be playing Scarborough Fair, which is an old English tune. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Thank you.
My name is Lukian Podilsky. I'm 17 years old. I've been playing piano for 11 years. I'm wishing you all a happy St. Patrick's Day here from home. Today, I'll be playing Irish Washerwoman. It is a traditional Irish piece. Enjoy.
Irish folk material and the other songs I've been playing, I wanted to present some music from the movies where there's a Celtic nature and theme. This first one is titled The Misty Mountains Cold. It's from the 2012 movie The Hobbit, An Unexpected Journey. It's the theme of the dwarves and it weaves itself through the whole trilogy. Enjoy. New Zealand composer David Lang. The last one of this set is by the composer Henry Mancini. It's the theme from the television miniseries from 1983, The Thornbirds, written by the Australian author Colleen McCullough. It describes life on a fictional sheep station of Drogheda in the outback of Australia. Drogheda is named after a town on the east coast of Ireland. I think you'll remember this one. Thank you.
This is a classic ballad performed by many, many singers. It has two names, the Londonderry Air or Danny Boy, with lyrics by Frederick Weatherly, written in 1913. Now, if you listen to the words, it would seem that it should be a woman singing this song, even though so many men have covered it in performance.
From glen to glen and down the mountainside, the summer's gone and all the roses falling. 'Tis you must go and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, white with snow. For I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, I love you so. But when ye come, and all the flowers are dying, if I am dead, is dead, I will maybe. You'll come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say an Ave there for me.
Think that it might be a father saying goodbye to his son as he's going off to war. Or some believe that it's a lament sung by an Irishman leaving his home country as he immigrates to the new world. Many, many interpretations, but I hope you enjoyed mine. This is one of my favorites. It's titled Star of the County Down. County Down is located in Northern Ireland. Words are by Cathal McGarvey, who lived from 1866 to 1927. He was a humorist, a storyteller, and a songwriter. A young man meets the beautiful Rosie McCann and, through the three verses of the song, imagines himself marrying her. Enjoy.
Near Banbridge Town in the County Down, one morning last July, down a boring green came a sweet colleen, and she smiled as she passed me by. She looked so sweet from her two bare feet to the sheen of her nut brown hair. Such a coaxing elf, sure I shook myself just to see she was really there. From Bantry Bay to Derrykeen, from Galway to Dublin town, now a maid I've seen like the brown colleen that I met in the County Down. As she onward sped, sure I scratched my head I said, says I, to a passerby, was the maid with the knacked brown hair. He smiled at me with pride, says he, that's the gem of Ireland's crown. Now Rosie McCann from the banks of the Mern, she's the star of the county down. The Mantry Bay to Derry Key, from Galway to Dublin town. No maid I've seen like the brown Colleen that I met in the county down. At the harvest fair, she'll be surely there, so I'll dress in my Sunday clothes, with my shoes shone bright and my hat cocked right for a small vermilion brown rose. Horse I'll yoke, though my plow turn a rust-colored brown, till a smiling bride by my own fireside sits the star of the county down. From Mantry Bay to Derry Key, from Galway to Dublin town, no maid I've seen like the brown Colleen that I met in the county down. From Mantry Bay to Derry Key,
I can just imagine the both of them falling in love.
This one is called the Londonderry Hornpipe, and I happen to live not too far from the Londonderry neighborhood in North Edmonton. A hornpipe is a dance that's played in Ireland and Britain right from the 16th century to present day. And it was performed by sailors on sailing vessels as part of their entertainment, I guess, and recreation. And there are some movements that I researched, so you might want to try these with me. You turn and you look to the right, and then you turn and you look to the left, and then you sort of keep your balance as you're lurching on these heavy waves on heavy seas. And then you sort of finish up by pulling up those breeches or your pants front and back. So something like this, and then like that. You kind of lurch, keep your balance, and then you pull up those breeches front and back. This would be so much better if there was a real fiddler here, and maybe a drum and maybe a little accordion. But if you clap along, that'll give me some encouragement. The Londonderry Hornpipe.
Thank you.
would a St. Patrick's Day performance be if we didn't include something by the Irish Rovers? The song is titled The Unicorn Song, and it was by an American writer, poet, cartoonist, Shel Silverstein, written in 1962 in the book Where the Sidewalk Ends. The Irish Rovers recorded this in 1968. They had a TV show on CBC which ran for about 7 years. This Irish Canadian folk group had international guests, filmed in many locations, not only Ireland, and were just so joyful to watch. I remember watching them. So I'm going to give it a try. And if you know the words, please sing along. Too. In 2015, the Rovers filmed a 50th anniversary live performance in Nanaimo, BC. Now, I've heard that it's available on DVD and perhaps on demand. Now, their motto is one more year. So by now, it's about 55, 56 years. Would it be great to see them? You've been such a wonderful audience. And I hope that you have enjoyed this virtual performance for St. Patrick's Day. My name is Irena Tarnawsky, and I run the Tarnawsky Music Studio in North Edmonton. An Irish blessing to finish things off. May the road rise up to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and the rain fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of His hand. My last song is a tribute to Ireland, written by American songwriters Chauncey, Olcott, George Graff Jr., with music by Ernest Ball. It was written in 1912 and has been recorded over 200 times. Leaves you some gold.